I'm Sir Tap Tap, and let's play Mushimesama. If you grab this game, it's provided by the developer. This is one of Cave's shoot 'em ups. Like, they changed the scary copyright warning to say, this game is for use on Earth and by Earthian use only. That used to be a warning for Japan only. So I'm going to show you... Cave's games are sort of famous for difficulty, but... something that's sort of underrated is... Shoot-em-up games almost always have a very wide range of difficulty settings, so... As you can see, this game can start off very, very easy. There we go, something's actually shooting at us. So there's a very wide range of difficulty. I believe each mode on the main screen, like, basically goes up in difficulty. Like, there's Novice mode, which is obviously designed for novices. There's the original game. There's the arranged game, which is usually harder. I'm not sure in this exact case, but I at least assume it's harder. And then there's version 1.5, which I'm pretty sure is considered the hardest. I'll admit, I'm a little bit confused about Cave's versions of stuff. Like, I thought I was playing this on stream last week. Turns out I was playing Mushimesama Futari, which I figured was a different version of this, but no, it's a second game altogether. So... Cave's games can be a little bit confusing in terms of there's always lots of different versions, but this version is a pretty complete release in that it even comes with the version, well, there's a version 1.5 DLC that you can buy. Version 1.5 of this otherwise fairly hard to get. I'm not sure if this game had a 360 release or not. I know that Futari has a 360 release, otherwise it might just be arcade boards. I tried to collect all of Cave's 360 games, and I've got almost all of them at this point. I'm not entirely sure where the, like, which games don't have 360 ports and which games are, you know, like, I know Espigladia has a PS2 port, actually, but hopefully pretty much everything will come over to Steam. That's what I'm hoping for their Steam plans are anyway. See, as we can see, even the boss... quite tolerable, though they still at least try some slightly interesting patterns. Pretty minimal. We're just gonna use our bombs to spam past the boss, frankly. So you can definitely start somewhere, and you know, the way I recommend playing if it's your first shoot 'em up game, well, let me explain this. So a lot of people think shoot 'em ups are something that, like, not everybody can do. But it's not like an inborn talent or anything. It's really just getting used to the game and getting good at it through play. So what you really should do is just find a game that you like. Like, find a game that interests you and play it on the easiest difficulty and try to get a one credit clear just on the easiest difficulty. And then, you know, slowly ramp up until you can, you know, you might not ever be able to one credit clear the hardest difficulty, but, you know... Oh, just for purpose of contrast, I want to show you a certain enemy in this level before we get to the hard mode. For one thing, that enemy will be a lot harder. But everything will be crazy. These. Look at that. Okay. Nothing to worry about, right? For one weird thing, the previous menu actually means return to the main menu. And I'm going to be careful here. The one thing I will have to note... Cave did not do as good a job porting this as, quote, did Eschatos, because this game crashes kind of often. Let's see if this will crash. It didn't. All right. So it usually crashes either when starting the game itself, like at the press start screen, or when loading up one of these games. I have not had it crash mid-gameplay, fortunately. So yeah, here we're going to just ultra extreme difficulty. I love that. Are you prepared to battle sheer despair? Also with these shots, so as you can see here, this is sort of your medium shot, this is your wide shot, this is your more focused shot. We're gonna go with the normal. Also, on makes the game even harder, so we're gonna go with normal. I'm not gonna be able to one credit clear this. This is the supreme crazy maximum difficulty. I'm gonna try to use no more than one credit per level. But I just want to show you the first three levels in this crazy difficulty mode. So there's going to be credit feeding. I'm sorry. I don't really have too much time to play and get good at these. I love shoot 'em ups, but I never usually play them well enough. Alright, I never get to play them enough to be able to, like, one credit clear maximum difficulty stuff. So I just want to be able to show this off and hopefully not die too many times. So as you can see, dramatically more difficult. It's, you know, it's a bullet hell game now, whereas it basically was just a plain shoot 'em up before. These things and these stupid ladybug things are crazy annoying. They don't even shoot anything in the lower difficulties. But yeah, they're frankly enough for me to waste a bomb on now. Oof. Ah, I can't believe I dodged the hard part and got hit by the easy part. I thought I had a bomb left and I didn't. Oof. That was a panic bomb. I don't know why I'm explaining bombs. I have slightly more practice than before. Aw, damn it. Not that you would know it. I actually had a recording on this fail, which is kind of annoying because my throat is bothering me, so that may be one less recording I'm able to do this weekend. It wasn't the game's fault, though, like I said, not a perfect port because of the crash issues. I am playing this before release, so it's possible there's some day one patch or something that'll fix things, or it may be fixed by the time you watch this video regardless. But Eschatos was an absolutely perfect port, and I'm a teeny bit disappointed in the quality of Cave's first effort, but like I said, it is their first that I'm aware of, first PC game. Ah. I can't believe it. That was perfect until, well, the part where I died. Damn. But yeah, hopefully their other stuff is perfect. I really should have bombed on that. I don't need to explain my bomb. Stop doing the tap tap. But yeah, still, this game is, I mean, the game itself is fantastic. Great variety of difficulty modes. I'm so glad they included the 1.5. Even as DLC, you know, there's three other modes that you can play without DLC. It's not, you know, I don't think it's a problem. And if you, I forget the exact price, but it's, definitely a lot cheaper than getting a 360 disc, and vastly cheaper than getting an arcade board. So now you're gonna want to watch those tree enemies. Yeah, we don't like those tree enemies. Okay, we didn't actually see their full attack, but it's insane. We don't even have maximum attack power yet. This is kind of annoying. It's kind of funny that hard mode doesn't even have that mercy on you. It doesn't even start you with max health, or not max health. Max firepower. I'm not sure what Parker's getting into, but at least he's not interrupting me directly. Max power, there we go. When you do feed in a credit, it does have some mercy on you and gives you max power. Like I said, damn it. Don't expect to be able to, like, don't try to one credit clear the hardest difficulty your first time. Just, you know, pick an easier mode. And in my opinion, credit feeding your first time through isn't really a bad thing. Panicked. Just to, like, I do that usually to try and sort of just feel out the levels. But if you want to just start on a lower difficulty and you can one credit clear that before you try to get, you know, try to do this without taking many hits. So, you know, slight difference in difficulty in the two modes we've shown. I do want to at least show the third level. I don't want to just credit feed my way through the whole game. I'm already a little embarrassed for myself, but I do. There's a really cool. Well, level 3 is really cool for a reason I don't want to spoil. Ah, damn. Hopefully, we only use one credit on this level. Also, certain enemies will clear their bullets when they die, most won't. But you can use that to. Certain enemies, like, have almost impossible to dodge. I think some actually are impossible to dodge if you don't kill them. But then you just kill them and then their bullets go away. I'm not sure if there's any way to know without just watching which ones do that. Damn it, the bomb. We're probably going to end up eating two credits on this. I don't think we used one on the first level, so. We'll just say I have three credits. I want to show you at least up until the third boss, so. I just have unreasonable goals. I've only been able to play this for like maybe 3 hours, so I think actually that's an exaggeration. I've played like just a few times, but I wanted to be able to show this off, and I thought, I hope this level play isn't too embarrassing to watch. Also, one thing to know about this game, bombs really don't do very much damage. They do more damage than your normal attack, but bombs are mostly just to clear stuff. This isn't one of those games where you can just sort of try to burn through a boss by spamming bombs. I knew that was gonna go south. As you might have noticed, slowdown is a feature. Some of these attacks would be impossible if the game kept constant frame rate. So slowdown is a feature in shoot 'em ups. Some people don't get that. They're dumb people. Everything is very carefully designed. My pathetic score. So yeah, this level, as you will see very shortly, does something really cool. These guys would suck spamming it up. Get out of here. I guess everything spams in a bullet hell game, but... Get out of here, crickets. Nobody likes your style. Ah! You go slower when you do that focused attack, and... Oop. And sometimes you'll need to stop doing that slow movement. Parker! To dodge something. I have a pretty bad reaction for that. Like, I don't usually think to do that until too late. I'm at least starting to bomb sort of properly. I didn't really need to bomb those, but... Better to use a bomb when you didn't need to than to forget to bomb and die. Oof. So yeah, this level's gimmick is that you basically fight this boss throughout the entire level and just sort of break off pieces of him bit by bit, and it's really cool. And we actually get a 1-up if we manage to break off every piece before we destroy his head. I'm really missing my bombs right now. Ah, there we go. So in this, you kind of want to be more careful of the trash than you want to be of the main boss, because they're usually faster to take down, but they have some very dangerous attacks. So we're about halfway through him now. In terms of options, this game has no more than one of the 360 releases would have, for better or worse. Not quite as impressive as Eschatos in that sense either. It's also only 720p, as in there's no way, like, full screen will just do full screen 720p. The windowed mode is 720p. It's a 2D game, so I mean, there's only so much you can do about that, so I can't complain too much. I can complain, however, that the game has, like, freaked out when I've tried to change full screen a few times. Hopefully they do patch that. I've told the developers about all of that crap. So, I told their PR, but hopefully they're looking into that. And like I said, I do believe this is Cave's first PC game ever, let alone, you know, first Steam game, so hopefully, ow. Hopefully later releases have, all the kinks ironed out before release. Yeah, this game comes out November 5th, in case you're watching before the game releases. Embargo date's November 2nd, so anytime I get a game before embargo, I will do my best to release on that embargo date. Otherwise, if there's no specific embargo, I just try to go for a day before release, so I don't rush myself too much. And do remember, you do not have to play this mode. You do not have to play this mode on Ultra either. You can play it on Normal, and then it's considerably more manageable. But hey, It's not too bad. I mean, I've only played this for a few hours, and I'm already, you know, not constantly credit cheating. Though I haven't gotten to play a range mode yet. I forget if I told you that in this video. This is why I hate redoing videos. I forget what I've told you. But I haven't gotten to play all the modes yet either. I just played some normal, and I figured I could, you know, do novice without any issue. I was right, of course. Give me that. Ugh. And then I tried some ultra just to see how poorly I would do. And I figured, you know, one credit per match or per level isn't too abhorrent, considering my amount of practice and stuff. It's like, I want to show off shoot 'em ups well, but I mean, it takes a lot of practice to show them off, like, super high score stuff. But I'm not doing a score attack, so... Oh, also one thing, do not play a score attack if you don't know what that means. That prevents you from continuing and stuff. So, if you're just trying to play casually your first time, definitely be sure you're not accidentally playing that. Kind of suicidal, but you get a one-up if you destroy the... Yeah, if you destroy the arms completely before you destroy the head. I'm good enough to do that in normal mode, but not without consequences in this mode. Because the head's usually more dodgeable than that. And I think this thing's a sea butterfly, isn't it? It's not really a bug, but I'll let it slide. Futari has even less bug-like enemies, so I guess a sea butterfly isn't too off the mark. Aw. I needed a bomb for that one, and I didn't have a bomb. I'm not sure if I needed, but I mean, aw. That was a waste. I think that was one of those attacks where you're just supposed to, you know, destroy them to the next phase rather than, you know, be able to dodge. I guess I'll show you a teeny bit of the next level, but I won't continue credit feeding. I'll just, if I get a game over, I'll accept it. Uh-oh. Hmm. I guess I should still be moving, but... Aw, man, I could've taken... If I had dodged that, I could've just taken her down before the next thingy. I actually didn't bother playing too much past this level, even in the regular difficulty, so I would definitely start... See, there we go. I would definitely start credit feeding really bad somewhere in here. So after a certain point, even this level is pretty much new to me in terms of ultra mode. But we'll play until we die, I guess. But yeah, so far, I forgot to mention, this game plays great on my Surface Pro 3, so if you have pretty much any reasonably modern Intel i5 processor laptop, you can probably play this just fine. There was some slight, like, hitching when certain enemies spawned for the first time, not sure what that was about, but the game was totally playable. I maybe wouldn't play on the max difficulty, but damn. But yeah, totally playable, so if you got a laptop, you should be able to make it work. I mean, it ran on 360 with room to spare, so I guess it shouldn't be super surprising, but you never know with ports, really. Also, I haven't really been able to commentate on it, but the game has really great art. And yeah, we'll call it quits there. I would do a bit better if I weren't talking too, but it's always a fairly significant handicap in bullet hell games when you have to talk about them while playing them. Let's see how poorly I did. Did I at least do better than the last time I played this? Sure. Wait. Oh. Oh, yeah, I did way better apparently. Huh. Well, not way, but twice as much. But yeah, that is Mushihima-sama coming to Steam, and hopefully the first of a long parade of caves games on PC.